In flow through pipelines, there will be pressure drop. If a water is flowing at a pressure of 10 bar, it will go out at a pressure of 8 bar or something. So the pressure which is at the entry will not be there at the pressure at the exit. So that pressure drop should be estimated using some formula. In laminar flow, there is a formula called Hagen-Poiseuille's formula. So let us derive that formula for calculating the pressure drop in pipelines. So first of all, we need to know what is laminar flow or what is viscous flow. Viscous flow and laminar flow both are same. So a flow where du by dy exists, that means change in velocity with respect to the y direction, if there is exists, that is the first condition. Second thing, the viscous flow is the flow where tau is equal to mu into du by dy, the Newton's law of viscosity acts on the layer of the streamlines. And the very important condition is the Reynolds number that should be less than 2000, or in some cases the Reynolds number is considered as 3000 something for discriminating laminar flow, turbulent flow. So if it is less than 2000, surely it will be laminar flow or viscous flow. So the Reynolds number can be calculated using the formula rho Vd by mu. Let us consider a pipeline of radius capital R, and inside the pipeline let us consider a cylindrical element, and the cylindrical element is having a radius of small r and having a length of del x. And over that cylindrical element there is a ring element which is having a thickness of dr. Let us come to that ring element later. So first of all let us see the pressure which is on the AB face, that is taken as P. So if the pressure at the AB face is taken as P, the pressure at this CD phase, that will be that initial P plus dou P by dou X, change in pressure with respect to X direction for a distance of del X. And then we are going to see about the forces acting on the cylindrical element. So in the cylindrical element, pressure here is P. So we know that pressure is equal to force by area. That means force is equal to pressure into area. So the force which is acted by the pressure is that pressure into area. Area is the area of the face AB in the cylinder, that is pi r square, because the cylindrical element is having radius of small r. So P into pi r square is the pressure force acting on the face AB. Similarly, the pressure force acting on the face CD is dou P, P plus dou P by dou X into del X into the pi r square. In this side also the same area of pi r square is there. And the third thing, the shear force acting on the surface of the element. The surface means the circumference into its length. That is the overall surface of outer surface of the element. The circumference is 2 pi r and the length is del x. Therefore, the shear force will be acting on this 2 pi r into del x. The force due to the shear force is tau into 2 pi r del x. So these three forces are acting on this element, cylindrical element. Summation of all these forces acting on the direction is equal to zero if there is no acceleration. So let us assume there is no acceleration and the fluid is flowing in a constant velocity. P into pi r square, that is acting on the positive direction, and P into dou P by dou X into del X is opposite to the flow direction. So that's why the minus sign is there. The shear force will also resisting the flow, that's why minus sign is there. So these three forces are added together, the summation will be zero. So the same equation is there. Here we can find P into pi r square, we can multiply that into the bracket. So P pi r square minus P pi r square is there. So we can cancel it out, because here we can see a minus sign. So now we have this equation. Then we can cancel out this del x and del x here. Also we are having pi r here. Here also we are having pi r square. So r is remaining in the next step. Minus dou p by dou x into r minus 2 tau is equal to 0. Therefore tau is equal to minus dou p by dou x into r by 2. All the terms are taken to the right hand side. So this is the expression for the shear stress acting on the
a pipeline. So we can come to a conclusion that the shear stress is dependent only on this R, because dou P by dou X is a constant, only the R is a variable. So we can say that the shear stress is linearly related to this radius R. So the shear stress distribution will be a line that is linear reference to the radius R. So the shear stress distribution across the cross section is linear as it varies linearly with R. R is the radius, because dou P by dou X is constant. Then we are going to go to the velocity distribution in the viscous flow through the pipe. So we know that by Newton's law of viscosity, tau is equal to mu into dE by dy. Also we have derived an equation in the previous step, tau is equal to minus dou P by dou X into R by 2. So this is the equation that we have derived just in the previous step, and this equation is an universal equation, that is Newton's law of viscosity, tau is equal to mu into dE by dy. So in our condition, R is the, capital R is the radius of the pipeline and small r is the radius of the cylindrical element. So the distance between the wall and the cylindrical element is y, that is R, capital R minus small r. So here in our condition, y is equal to capital R minus small r. So dy is equal to, that is differentiation of that, that is minus dr, because r doesn't have r, small r term. So this Newton's law of viscosity now becomes tau is equal to minus mu into d by dr, because dy is replaced by minus dr, right? So then we are equating this equation what we got from the previous slide and the Newton's law of viscosity. So if you equate this, this is Newton's law of viscosity and this is the equation what we have got from the previous slide. So now we are adding the equation for du by dr. The minus mu is taken to the right hand side, so that becomes, the minus is nullified and it becomes plus, and mu is here. In the next step, we are integrating the u with respect to r. We have integrated that r square becomes r by 2, and now there is a constant of integration there. So we need to know the value for the constant of integration. So if you apply no slip boundary condition, no slip boundary condition means at the wall the velocity is zero. So at r, at small r is equal to capital R, that means when the radius of the element is equal to the radius of the pipeline, there the velocity will be zero. So now we are substituting the value of r and u in the equation number 2 what we got previously. So u is equal to 1 by 4 mu dou p by dou x into small r, that should be written as capital R squared plus c. So now we are bringing that c term to the left hand side, because we have to find the value of c. So here we have minus 1 by 4 mu into dou p by dou x into r squared. So now we are substituting this value of c in the previous equation. So already we have this equation, u is equal to 1 by 4 mu into dou p by dou x plus c. Now we are substituting the value of c here. So if we substitute the value of c here, all the terms are the same except the small r and capital R. So u is equal to the whole term into small r square minus capital R square. So now always the small r will be smaller than this capital R, because the element which is inside the pipeline will be smaller than the total radius of the pipeline. So the capital R should be taken to the left hand side. So R square, capital R square minus small r square is written here. So as it is interchanged, we have introduced this negative sign here. So this is the equation for the distribution of velocity u along the cross section of the pipeline. So here we can see the velocity is dependent on r squared. This r is constant, radius of the pipeline, this rho p by dou x is also constant, viscosity is also constant, 1 by 4 is also constant. The only variable is r square. So which means u will change exponentially with respect to r. So velocity distribution across the cross section is parabolic as it varies exponentially with r. So we can see the distribution is parabolic since it changes exponentially with respect to r. Whereas in the previous case we have found that the shear stress distribution is linear with respect to the radius r because it was dependent on r. Here it is r squared. So let us go to the next thing. The ratio of maximum velocity to the average velocity. We know that where the velocity is maximum at the center. So at the center the velocity will be maximum and at the wall the velocity will be zero as we apply no slip boundary condition. So at the center means the small r should be zero there. So at small r is equal to zero the velocity will be maximum. So u is equal to minus 1 by 4 mu dou p by dou x. This is the formula that we have derived in the previous case. The u max can be calculated by substituting r is equal to 0. So if small r is equal to 0, only the capital R term will be there, small r term will not be there. So this is the formula for maximum velocity. Now we have to calculate the formula for average velocity. So consider the flow through the ring element that we have discussed first slide. In the ring element, the flow dq is velocity at the radius r and area of the ring element. So here u is the velocity at that radius r and 2 pi r is the circumference of the circle and dr is the thickness of the circle. And then already we have the formula for u. U is 1 by 4 mu minus 1 by 4 mu into dou p by dou x into capital R square minus small r square into 2 pi r dr. Just we have substituted the value of u here. And then this is the discharge only for the through the small ring element. So in order to calculate the discharge through the whole pipe, we have to integrate by 0 to r. R is the radius of the pipe. So 0 to r dq. So here 1 by 4 mu by dou p by dou x, 2 pi, all these things are constants. So we are bringing to the left hand side of the integration. So here this r should be multiplied inside that, so it becomes capital R square small r and small r cube. So now if we integrate this r becomes r square by 2 and this r cube becomes r power 4 by 4. Then substituting the limits will give you this thing. And then let us take the LCM for this. So the 4 will be the LCM and we will get r power 4 because it will become 2r power 4 minus 1r power 4, that will become 1r power 4. So we have 2, 4 and 4 here. So if you cancel out this 2 and 4 here, 2 will be there. 2 into 4, that will become 8. 1 by 8 mu minus dou p by dou x into r power 4 is the equation for discharge. So average velocity u is equal to q by area. So discharge we have found out, this is the equation. So divided by area is pi r square. So we can cancel out this pi. Here we can see r square, r power 4 by r square. So we can cancel out that. So now we have the equation for average velocity. So already we have the formula for maximum velocity and now we got the formula for average velocity. So maximum velocity by average velocity, we can see that everything can be cancelled except this 4 and 8. So it will become 2. So the ratio of maximum velocity by average velocity is 2. That means the maximum velocity will be 2 times the average velocity. So the maximum velocity that is at the center will be double the average velocity through the pipe. Okay, then the key thing, that is pressure drop in the viscous flow, that is our key objective. So already we have the equation for average velocity u dash. So here we have the term minus dou p by dou x. Dou p by dou x is nothing but the pressure drop. Dou p by dou x is 8 into mu u dash divided by r square. So now we are integrating this term, this dou p by dou x, and it becomes 1 to 2 8 mu u dash divided by r square into dx. So now we are applying the limits x1 minus x2 and p1 minus p2 here. So now we have interchanged that x1 minus x2 as x2 minus x1 because this x2 value will be greater. Let us see that later. So this is the case. So x1 is the distance between the reference point and the first point where we measure the pressure p1, and x2 is the second point where we measure the pressure p2. So x1 will be always less than the x2, so that's why we have interchanged that x2 and x1. X2 will be greater. So as we have interchanged x2 and x1, here the minus sign has been removed here, right? So now we have the equation p1 minus p2 is 8 mu u dash divided by r square into l. L is nothing but this x2 minus x1. X2 minus x1 will be this l, that is the length of the pipeline. So now we have just replaced that r by diameter by 2, radius by diameter by 2, and then this is the formula for calculating the pressure drop. P1 minus P2 is equal to 32 mu u dash L by D square. So sometimes we may ask to calculate the pressure drop in terms of head. So drop in pressure head. So that means pressure drop in terms of head means P1 minus P2 divided by rho g. So we have to divide that term by rho g. So simply divide the 32 mu u dash L by D square by rho g will give you the formula for pressure head loss. So this equation is called Hagen-Poiseuille's equation or Hagen-Poiseuille's formula. This is used to calculate the difference in pressure head, and if you want to simply calculate the pressure loss, we can use this formula, 32 mu u dash L by D square. Thanks for watching. Don't forget to subscribe.